which had to be constantly sharpened or replaced, creating work for coppersmiths. When this task was completed, they dug a tunnel, running steeply down into the rock, and a burial chamber was carved out deep underground. This was the first of three such chambers, which would eventually lie beneath or within the finished structure. Nearly all of the pyramids contained a subterranean structure, as well as an internal system, although no two of these were the same. Much of the next 10 years were taken up with quarrying and shaping measured blocks of limestone from a site in the Mokhtar Hills. These blocks formed the great foundation, which covered 13 acres. The transportation of the finished building blocks from the quarry to the site at Giza depended, as so much of Egyptian life did, on the flood pattern of the Nile. When the water level was at its height, the blocks were floated downstream on barges. They were then unloaded onto a specially constructed landing wharf. A massive ramp was also built, via which the great blocks could be hauled to their destination as the pyramid took shape. Cheops Pyramid, built in the late 4th dynasty, contains 2,003,000 blocks of stone, some weighing as much as 60 tons. Some of the largest stones were used to form the roofs of the burial chambers. The enormous stone tomb, known as a sarcophagus, in which the body of the pharaoh was to be laid, was first lowered into the burial chamber. The sarcophagus would have been far too large to carry through the complex small tunnels. This was done by filling the chamber up with sand, hauling the sarcophagus on top, then removing the sand from the chamber, which in turn gradually lowered the tomb. The sarcophagus was finally placed into a hole, which was specially prepared for it in the floor of the burial chamber. When this was done, more sand was then piled in, this time forming a mound on top of which the giant slabs of stone could be supported as they were set in position over the chamber. The stones were arranged to lean into one another, forming a roof shape, so that when the sand was removed, each took the weight of the opposing stone. The weight of the stones, which would be built on top of this roof, would further push the stones together.